Stay burning, my friends.
Yeah!
West Coast, San Jose, California. Your buddy Dusty Cat is here with his Christmas tree. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Look at that. You got Twilight Sparkle and Rainbow Dash, and you got all of the stuff over here. You got Spike up there. Look at that. Isn't that cool? That's awesome. That's all Caradon right there. That's awesome. Thank you very much for taking time out of your busy week to come and visit with us tonight, because we have for you, straight from the North Pole itself, one Josefina Helion.
Good enough.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, good enough.
I'm an American. I can't speak Swedish. There you go.
It's okay.
Good
I
enough.
Do.
Good enough. You speak Swedish enough for both of us.
Yeah.
Yes, so Fina is here. Fina, best known as Swedish voice actress of Princess Luna, Derpy, and the Great and Powerful Trixie.
Yes.
Among others, Silver Spoon.
And Silver Spoon,
yes. And I'm sure some side characters in there, like, I'm sure she's the fifth voice of Bon Bon.
Yeah.
The fifth American voice of Bon Bon.
Oh, yeah.
I can't taste my tongue. Yeah. Oh, we in a good mood tonight, folks. In a good mood tonight. Yes, we are.
Always.
Always in a good
mood. I always try to be in a good mood.
Yes. So, we're going to put you all right up over my right shoulder here so everybody can see your beautiful looks and your beautiful face. Get up there. There it is.
That's exactly how I look today.
Nice.
Right now.
Absolutely. Two in the morning. Yeah. Got up for you guys. Just curled the hair.
Yep, I have a gala dress.
Gala dress.
I have a gala dress on.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Absolutely. You know what? I think she's got her slippers on, guys.
Oh yeah. Right. Definitely.
It's polar wear. We're gonna get right into it. Right into it. Here we go.
Yep.
Questions for you. First, what are some of your earliest memories of cartoons and comics that appealed to you? It's going to be different. I had the same question for Sibsy last week, American Canadian comics and cartoons. Mm-hmm. What were you guys seeing over there in Europe?
Let's see. The first memories, that's a hard one.
Mm-hmm.
I have a really vivid memory. My grandmother
mm-hmm.
was in a church. That's not the Swedish church. He was in a different kind of church, mm-hmm. and they made cartoon videos of Bible stories.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And I didn't actually believe any of the stories because, you know, they all believed it, they were all true.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't believe they were true, but I loved the stories from mm-hmm. the Bible, like Daniel in the Lion's Den mm-hmm. and the creation and you know, all of that.
Mm-hmm.
So I remember watching a lot of that, and then it was in Swedish, of course.
Uh-huh.
And now when I meet actors and at the studio and uh-huh. they talk to me, and I'm like, you're in that cartoon
uh-huh.
from this church that yeah, I was in that. And it's so absurd when you actually meet the voices behind the characters that you grew up
Oh yeah.
watching,
Oh yeah.
and you're like, okay, stuff is happening in my head right now. This
Yeah.
is so weird. I am talking to Daniel from Daniel in the Lion's Den, or I'm talking to other biblical people
That's cool.
that I was watching. Yeah, and I'm not religious myself, so it's really strange that that is like one of my most vivid memories from cartoons when I was little. But I really loved them.
Oh, that's cool.
It was like these three teenagers that went back through time and visited these different places and these different happenings in the Bible. It's kind of weird.
Sort of
But,
like Bill and Ted's Excellent Holy Adventure.
Kind of.
Kind of.
Kind of not.
Kind of not, though.
Yeah, sure.
You're not only an actress, but you are also a model, right?
Yeah.
A model.
Yeah.
Look at this beautiful model shot over my right shoulder.
I've done some modeling. It's not
yes.
a lot, but
not a lot.
Sure.
Look at that. Look at the beautiful little the left arm out, you know, the hand on the knee. It's beautiful with the ponytail. It's gorgeous. Lovely.
Oh, you stop it.
No, I'm not going to stop it. Beautiful.
Flatterer.
But yeah, I am. But tell us a bit about modeling. And how does it feel, you know, being a model, you know, when you're on a shoot? What's that all about?
The shoots that I've done have been really mellow and not like huge productions. So it's been kind of they've been on a budget and it's not big and huge, but it's been a lot of fun.
Oh, cool.
Because I haven't done a lot of it, so it's really a challenge.
Mm-hmm.
And anybody who follows me on Twitter knows I love a challenge.
Mm-hmm.
So I find it really challenging, and it's hard to keep an energy level up so you don't look like you're just standing there.
Bored.
You should look like, bored. Oh, you're changing the light again. Okay. Oh, I need touch up again. Oh, okay, fine. But it takes so much energy to keep energy level up, and it's kind of the same in the studio. You have to keep your energy up. You can't just say the lines.
Right.
You just have to have something behind it,
right.
And it's the same. You can't just stand there.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody who watches America's Next Top Model knows this.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm a huge America's Next Top Model fan. So
what about RuPaul's drag show? Seen that one?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's hilarious stuff there.
I haven't seen that much. I've seen a few things, and that's just he's I love that guy.
He's out there. I love it.
He is out there, and
I broke the guest, people. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I need to get another image in my head.
That's okay.
No, but it's great. It's great. No, don't be sorry. No, so it's great. I like it. It hasn't been too much modeling now since the kid.
Yes, you are a mother now.
Yes,
14-month-old son, I hear.
Yes, his name is Edison.
Edison.
Agathon.
Oh.
Agathon.
Agathon.
Sounds kind of Greek. We say
sounds
Agathon.
Kind of Greek.
It's, yeah, it is Greek from the beginning. But in Swedish, we say Agathon.
Okay.
Yeah, so it sounds
named,
more
named after
Greek
a Greek
language.
Hero of some kind?
He is actually named from a cartoon from when we were little.
Okay.
It was, he looked like a little, he was like a private eye.
Okay.
And he had a little hat on, a little round hat. I don't know what you call that in
mm-hmm.
English, but a little round hat, a mustache,
mm-hmm.
and kind of fat. And his name was Agathon Sachs, which means Agathon Scissors.
Ooh. Okay.
Strange name. Yes, totally strange name. But he was great, and I loved him as a kid, and so did my fiancé. And we also love Agatha Christie.
Okay.
So Agatha is, you know, the male form of Agatha is Agathon.
Oh, awesome.
And she also has a private eye character
mm-hmm.
called Hercule Poirot, if you've heard of him.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Hercule Poirot, he is also a crime solver. And when I was pregnant, we were in London and saw The Mousetrap.
Oh, cool.
That Agatha Christie wrote, and it's been in the West of like 60 years or something.
Yeah.
Uninterrupted. Yeah. It's crazy. So it was like we had a long list of names when he arrived, and none of them felt right. And I was like, I was thinking about Agatha. What do you think? And my fiance started to cry. He's like, yes, that's his name.
Nice.
Yeah, so not much modeling after him. I had a few pounds to lose.
Yeah, it's working on that, aren't we? Now, we're all working on that.
Yeah. So I started Weight Watchers, and I started working out, and I have lost like 25 pounds.
Nice.
Yeah. Nice.
You're way ahead of me. It I'm only down 7. So.
But that's, hey, keep going.
Working on it.
Keep going, Dusty.
Princess Luna. Trexe, yeah. Silver Spoon, they are all have a little touch of rebelliousness in them.
Time to time. I don't know if they're typecasting me.
Any one of those more fun to play than the others?
That is a tricky one. I like them all. But let's start with Trixie.
Okay.
Or let's start with Luna, because she's a princess and she should go first.
Okay, I love the Luna graphic back over my shoulder then, because I just changed it. There we go.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay, you're done. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. Okay, but no, I love to play Luna. She's so conflicted within herself, you know, because of her past, this Nightmare Moon, and it's like she always has the devil on her shoulder following her every move.
Yeah.
And Nightmare Moon is always going to be a part of her, and I really like that. That makes her interesting.
Yes.
And I saw this fan movie, Children of the Night.
Oh my god, this is so good.
I'm obsessed with it.
Yes.
Yes, I am. And I'm obsessed with it. I love it so much. I've been reading my contracts to see if I can translate it and do it in Swedish.
Wow, that'd be cool.
Oh yeah, that would be so cool. And I'm going to contact the creators of it and see if they can hand me some karaoke backgrounds or the background they used, or
nice.
See if they can help me with that. So
I'm sure they will. I
really hope I can make that true, because I love it. And since Luna doesn't sing on a show, what's up with that? When are my
what's
characters going to get some singing
what's
to
up
do?
With that?
Yeah, what's up with that? I wanted to be proactive and like, well, if they won't give me something to sing, I'll sing it myself and I'll find it. Yeah, that's why I love that one. Okay, so Silver Spoon. She's a great character. I mean, she's kind of a bully. But she creates conflicts.
Yes,
that's always an interesting character to play.
She's kind of the bully that follows the bully.
Yeah.
She seems to be that character that wouldn't be a bully if not for Diamantiro.
No, it's like that's the friend she made, and her friend is like that, so she just mimics and follows her around.
Right.
Which I kind of feel bad for her. I would like to know more about her and get some background on both of them.
That's one of the things that I felt after this week's episode, which had them step up their bullying to another level.
Yeah, that was horrible.
It was horrible. But I, as a fan, I'm not sure if any of the other fans want to, but I, as a fan, want to know why.
Yeah.
Most bullies have a reason.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay?
Exactly.
So why are these two the way they are? I want some backstory on these two to find out what is causing their gears to turn that way.
Yes, me too.
Yes.
I would be really interested in that, actually.
Yes, I would.
Because I think that's an interesting backstory.
Mm-hmm. Needs to be told.
It needs to be told, definitely. Trixie. That's another. I really like her. Also, because she also creates conflicts. Mm-hmm. But in the adult Ponyville.
Yes.
I mean, Silver Spoon is more among the younger citizens of Ponyville, right?
Right.
And Trixie is interacting with the adult part of Ponyville.
Mm-hmm.
And she's so confident that it borders on arrogance.
Yes.
It is, yeah, it is arrogance. She is arrogant.
She's arrogant.
But I like her. And the difference I feel between Silver Spoon and, let's say, Trixie, is that the adults don't feed into her crap. They don't listen to it. But the kids, like Scootaloo, just now, she listens to Silver Spoon and Diamond Tiara when they say things that aren't true.
Well, of course,
because they're kids.
They're kids. They don't have the confidence in themselves to just tell that person, "Ah, I don't need you."
Exactly. And Trixie, she wants the adults and she wants the ponies to listen to her, and they don't because she's so arrogant, and so she becomes more arrogant. So they will listen to her, but they listen even less. So I kind of feel bad for her. She's a good pony at heart, and she wants to be a hero, and I admire that.
And maybe it'll happen now that she's had her redemption.
Yeah, let's hope.
Maybe.
I think she deserves to be a hero.
Yes.
She deserves to save the day.
And there is this 5-second snippet, the only thing I could find in Swedish that had any quality whatsoever of you, was where Luna in Swedish says, "Huzzah, how many points do I receive?"
Yes.
Yes.
So
I've got it over my shoulder right now. It's not a video, it's just a picture of her. So can you give me the huzzah?
I will give you the whole line.
Okay.
How about that? Ta-da! Hur många poäng får jag för det där?
I love it. Sweet. Sweet.
Yeah, she's such a
smart. How did you approach her in that episode as, you know, bratty teenager? Because that's sort of how it came off in the English version. When she didn't get her way, you know. So it's sort of like she comes down from on high and expects it to be the way it was. And then when she didn't get it, she was sort of like the brat.
Yeah, she was kind of bratty, wasn't she?
Kind of bratty.
Yeah, I think I followed the English pretty much. She was I followed the English. I try to stay true to the original as much as I can, and if I really get a sense of something, I follow that, but usually I follow the original as much as I can. And she was kind of weird in that episode, I found. But it's probably because I'm not a teenager anymore. So what was your question?
Don't worry about it. That's quite enough. I know it's 2 a.m. We'll just keep... We're going on. Speaking of Nightmare Nights, you go all out on the Halloween, don't you? All out.
Sometimes I do.
Look at this picture, people. You see that? That's Fina.
That's me.
That's Fina as Elphaba from Wicked.
Yes, it totally is.
Doesn't that look like she was actually in the show? No. This is a cosplay, people. That is gorgeous.
Thank you. I worked hard on it, so thank you. That means a lot.
That is. That's like one of the... I did a Daring Do costume, but I didn't paint myself brown. Wow.
Why?
I don't know. I should have. maybe I'll do that for BabsCon. No. But, beautiful. Beautiful costume.
Thank you. Thank you.
And
I loved it. I loved every second of it.
That is, and we've had this discussion, that's one of your dream roles, right?
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Because you sing and record and all that stuff. What are some of the other dream roles you might have?
Yes, I have another dream role right now, actually. Just started obsessing about this role like a few weeks ago. And it's Molly. From the musical Ghost.
Ghost the Musical.
Yes. And I started obsessing over that a few weeks ago. I am such a nerd. And I listened to it like forwards and backwards. And I love it. And I love that part. And it's so much emotion. And that. So that's one. That's one. Elphaba's one. Molly is one. Mm-hmm. I've had like a secret dream to play Christine from Phantom also since I was like 10 years old.
Yes.
And I have a lot of dream parts. I'm just choosing wisely.
Choose wisely, yes.
I am.
Or choose Wesley, one or the other. Yeah.
What?
I don't know. Star Trek? I don't.
Okay. I got it.
I'm going to move, people. I'm sorry.
Yeah, but I'm okay.
You've also done, mm-hmm. and Pixel Kitties is going to go squee in about 2 seconds. You've also done Monster High.
Yeah,
she is a huge Monster High fan. The amount of dolls that girl has, I have no idea where she keeps them all. But
really?
Yes. Which characters did you play on Monster High?
I play Abby Domino.
Mm-hmm.
She's the Russian.
Okay.
She's a Russian.
Awesome.
And she's awesome.
Yes.
She is so much fun to play because she says the most strangest things. She always has the strange anecdotes from mm-hmm. her home village in Russia.
Okay.
I really like her. I also play Twyla.
Okay.
And Claudia.
Claudia. You got half the cast going here.
Yeah. So those are a few of the characters I think I'm a couple more, but I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say, so I won't.
Not been released yet. Don't talk about it.
Don't talk about it. No, but they did a release of the movie,
mm-hmm.
13 Wishes.
13 Wishes.
Where I play the, oh my God, the mean genie. But I've totally lost her name.
Ah. I'm sure Pixel was here right now. Pixel, get on Skype and tell me who that is. I'm sure she'll... 2 seconds. Come on, Pixel. Come on, get on.
Bad voice actress.
That's okay. It's fine.
I can't for the life.
I don't know. It's like, you can't ask Kathy Westlock, you know, her, you know, which character from what, because she's played 1,000 characters. It's like, was that from 1901? Just too many of them.
No, that's kind of where I am right now.
But that's awesome. That means you're getting work and you're great.
Thanks. Absolutely. Yeah, well, I tried.
Mm-hmm. And then you also played our very favorite mayor on the whole program. The mayor that shall not be named in marketing or advertising. Derpy.
Derpy!
Derpy!
I love her.
Yes.
I really love her, and I think it's self-explanatory as to why I love her, mm-hmm. and I think every pony knows what I mean.
Yes.
So I won't give you any explanation. I'll only say more Derpy, more Derpy for please. Every pony.
Now, they had the big controversy over here.
Yeah.
Of course, about the whole voicing thing.
Yeah.
So we haven't actually seen a clip of that over here, how you did. So do you have her voice in the back of your head? Like, right there, that maybe you could bring her out and introduce her to us real quick.
I think so. Let's see. What's her line in Swedish? I think it's,
Now that's the voice I can live with. Yes.
That's how I
remember. Cute! Oh my goodness,
yeah,
that's so cute.
So cute. Are you okay, Rainbow Dash?
Yeah. So cute.
She's so sweet.
You are a self... labeled huge geek.
Yeah.
Aren't you? Huge geek.
Yeah.
Tell us a bit about, you know, most geeks obsess over certain things. I mean, we all obsess over MLP. We all obsess over other stuff. What are some of the stuff that you're obsessing over in your geekitude at the moment? Or your favorite geek thing?
My favorite geek things are, I love TV shows. We watch a lot of TV shows here. I love Cougar Town. I'm really geeky about Cougar Town. It's Courtney Cox
mm-hmm.
show. Her new show, and I love the cast. The cast is just, I love it. I'm obsessed with it. I'm obsessed with Castle.
Okay.
And mostly Nathan Fillion because mm-hmm. he's my Hollywood crush. He is. He's dreamy. I don't tell my fiance I said that.
It's 2 in the morning. He can't hear you.
No, I know, right? Maybe he'll listen to this. Crap. I love you, honey. No, but he obsesses over it too. He was this huge Firefly fan, and he made me watch it, and I was
Yes.
like, no, but I'm not sure I want to watch. And I got obsessed with that too, and I was
Yes.
like, he's a billionaire, awesome. And what else? And I think I know every line to Friends.
Ha
I am a huge Friends fan, and Modern Family. We actually just started watching it like a couple of months ago because we watch so many shows that we can't follow everything we
Of
want to
course.
follow.
Yeah.
So we're like, okay, what do we start to know? Like, we have like 3 seasons of Modern Family. Should we start watching because we heard so much about it?
Wow.
And we just watched 3 seasons straight almost. Like every night when the kid was sleeping, we were like, Modern Family. And we are laughing our behinds off. It's so funny, and I love every single character. I mean, I have a very soft spot for Phil Dunphy, though.
Yeah,
Do you watch it?
I just got back. No, I got back into my anime because I was a huge anime head back when I was younger.
Ah,
So, but now
okay.
Netflix has a lot of
Yeah.
anime, right? And it's all these
Oh.
titles that I've never heard of before. I'm going, oh, I'll give this one a watch. It's only 22 minutes, and then I found this really crazy, weird one that's like Edge of Adult, and it's like, wow, it's 45 minutes long per episode, six episodes. Oh, okay, I'll watch one. Whoa, this
Oh
is
my
so
God.
cool. And we chain smoked them last night. I think we chain smoked five of them last night, didn't we, honey? Yes. Oh, by the way, the wonderful girlfriend Amy is here. Say hi, Amy.
Yay.
I'm every pony.
Yeah, see, she's over there making bracelets beating.
She sounds sweet.
She is sweet. She's awesome. She's an awesome girlfriend. Um,
No, so
hearth,
what's
hearth, yes.
yeah,
Hearthswarming
cool.
Eve, otherwise known as Christmas, is here. Yes. So, being Swedish,
Being
is there
Swedish.
any family traditions, Swedish family traditions up there that you have that you can let us in on?
I mean, every family has their own, of course.
Yes.
But I am not a huge tradition girl. I like to mix things up. And since you're in a relationship, one year you
Yeah.
had his parents, and since everybody's divorced nowadays, my parents are divorced, his parents are divorced, so we're kind of splitting our time. And now, since our son is in the picture, everybody wants us to come.
Everybody wants a piece of the
Yeah.
grandkid.
But please, can't you come to us? Yeah, is it us you want to see, or is it the baby? Yeah, don't answer that.
Da baby.
Okay. Anywho, yeah. Totally the baby. So not huge. I mean, Sweden has traditions that not the rest of the world has. I don't know if you saw the clip that I uploaded to Twitter the other day about Lucia.
No, I
The
didn't.
13th of December
Okay.
is Lucia.
Okay.
And I uploaded on Twitter the Lucia, Swedish Lucia for Dummies on Twitter. So it's a really Swedish holiday. It's originally from Italy, and I don't really know why it's still here. But so the 13th of December is Lucia, and the kids dress up with you have to watch the clip if
Oh,
you're
I'll watch
interested.
it.
Watch the clip
I'll watch it later.
because it's kind of strange.
Kind of strange.
It's funny.
Strange is cool.
It's right, I
Yeah.
know. Watch that. It's kind of fun.
Will do.
And yeah, do it. Otherwise, I'm not. I always do something though. On all my presents that I give, I have to seal them. With the red stick. You hold it over a candle. I'm not sure what it's named in English,
Right.
but we call it lucky.
Okay.
And we hold it over the candle so that it melts. And you seal the present with it, and you put a stamp on
Put the
it,
family seal.
yeah.
It's like how they did it in the old days when a king sent a missive to somebody. He took the
Exactly.
wax and put it on the letter. I'm like,
Yeah,
yeah,
the
that's for me.
wax. That's what you call
Go.
it. Yeah.
Yes.
The wax. Sure,
The
that's what
wax
you call it.
seal. Yes.
Yeah, and that's something I always do
That's
because the
cool.
smell is Christmas to
That's
me.
cool. That's like
It
personalized.
is.
That's taking it another level. That's personalized to another level.
Yeah, well, I love the smell of it. It smells like Christmas. And that's my dad. He brought that into the family, and I still do that. So.
Well, that's cool. So yeah. We are at commercial time. So we're going to go to commercial. And when we come back, we're going to go over convention. And then we're going to go into charity. We're going to go in last week's charity. We're going to get your charity coming up. And when we're done with that, we're going to bring in Screwball to get all your questions out there in TV land for this wonderful lady who's staying up with us tonight. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Hey, you. Yes, you. Do your friends make fun of you because you can't spell the word dog? Does your pyromaniac little sister use your books as kindling? Are your fanfics infested with Draconequus? Boy, do we have the solution for you. Oh, yes, we do. Come visit Ponyville's own Golden Oaks Library, where your head archivist is our very own Princess Twilight Sparkle. Drop in, check us out, get lost in a book. If Rainbow Dash can do it, so can you.
Please remember to reshelve all books in the proper Dewey Decimal System location. No gum-chewing, dubstep, mad science, exploding ponies, or party cannons allowed. Those on holidays, winter wrap-up, and whenever Equestria is doomed. Don't text and drive.
That's right, ponies. Golden Oaks Library has every book you could ever need. If you need it and they don't have it, they'll send it off to Canterlot to get it for you. Go down and see our Princess Twilight Sparkle, and she will turn you on to any genre of literature you could ever want. Any of them.
Yeah!
If you don't go down there, I think she's got a list now. She has a list of every pony in Ponyville who hasn't been to the library, and she's going to come knock on your door and find out why you're not reading a book. Because she's like that. But we're back with Fina.
Yeah, we're
back. First things first, conventions, BabsCon, San Francisco, California, April 18th through 20th, 2014. These are the people that are going to be there. Andrea Libman, GM Barrow, M.A. Larson, Amy Keating Rogers, Megan McCarthy, Brian and Brianna Drummond. Music by Eurobeat, Brony, Fanning, Tarby, Michael A., and maybe Mike the Microphone if I can drag his butt over from Sacramento. They also have a new membership level. It's called the Evil Membership. Evil. Go over to their website and find out what that's all about.
Yeah, I was just going to ask.
Absolutely.
That.
That's.
I want to do a con so bad.
Evil.
Oh, it's evil. No.
It's evil. But check that out. And then, if you have any questions at all, you can go to Ask Their Mascot Tumblr. Golden Gates has her own Tumblr. And that is Ask Golden Gates on Tumblr, so check that out. BronyCon vendor applications are out, so go to Bronyville or BronyCon and get the vendor applications if you don't have one yet. And submissions for Everfree Northwest panels. For Everfree Northwest is open, so make sure you go over there if you want to do a panel for Everfree Northwest. Charity time. Charity time.
Yeah.
Last show's charity was Sabrina. Sabrina was the BC Lions Society for Children with Disabilities, also known as Easter Seals. We did 628 bits with a $100 bit match by Care to Win at 728 bits on a 500 bit goal. Thank you very much. You guys are awesome. And this year we are, drumroll please, 23,528 dollars across all charities. So thank you very much. We have two more shows to go. Let's see if we can hit 25 by the end of the year. Two shows to go. So we are going to give away this vinyl scratch pop figure right here. Not only that, but because we hit 500 bones, Sibsy herself is mailing me today six comic books with one of each of the main six done with the covers done by her, signed with a doodle, that's a drawing, people, a doodle in the Twilight Sparkle issue for you. And that goes to the person whose name I draw out of this hat right here. So I'm going to dig deep in this hat. Kind of looks like a Santa hat. Why? Because it is. And dig, dig, dig. We're gonna get the one at the very bottom. We're gonna go all the way down here by the pom pom. But you know, my finger's like right there. I'm getting this one right there. Get it? Get it? That one? That one? Nope. This? Nope. That one? Yes. This one. Okay. No. Don't drop it on the floor. Nope. 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 Get it. Daniel Deasy. Daniel Deasy. You win this one. So as soon as I get those comics and I get information from you, I will mail that stuff to you.
And congratulations, Daniel.
Congratulations, Daniel. And if you want to get a hold of me at dusty@manlyandjabroni.com, just send me an email with your contact info, who you are, and what you won. I will mail it to you as soon as possible. Now, let's get in the spirit of the thing. Putting a hat on. I got my hat on. I got my Santa hat. I got my Santa vest made by me, myself. Now, oh, I'm going to take a drink because I'm getting parched. Real quick. Arnold Palmer. Lemonade and iced tea. And Fina.
Yeah.
The Gina Davis Institute on Gender in Media.
Yeah.
For you, founded by who? Gina Davis. Her name's in it. You think she founded it? 2004, Academy Award winning actor, advocate Gina Davis. The Institute and its programming arm, see Jane, are at the forefront of changing female portrayals and gender stereotypes in children's media entertainment. The Institute is uniquely positioned to spotlight gender inequalities at every media and entertainment company through cutting-edge research, education, training, strategic guidance, and advocacy. Our mission is to work within the entertainment industry to dramatically, alter how girls and women are reflected in the media. Correct?
Correct.
Yes. So how did yes. you? How did these people come to your attention?
Well, since I work with the cartoons, mm-hmm. and I also get cast as the female characters.
Yes, you do.
And wow. Yes, a lot, actually. Weird. And it's, I kind of saw like a red thread, you say in Swedish, but I don't know if you say that in English, but I could see similarities between mm-hmm. the female characters. And that they, now MLP, Pony is not one of these right. shows, because the main characters are all women and mm-hmm. they talk about something else than boys.
Right.
And so that, this is not part of that. It's a lot of other shows that, well, Gina Davis says it best. She has a great video mm-hmm. On what they do and what the statistics are.
Uh-huh.
And there are so much fewer female characters than there are male characters.
Mm-hmm.
So, and the male characters do a bunch of stuff, do crazy adventures and do a bunch of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the female characters are often the ones that stays behind, maybe tells,
mm-hmm.
you know, the tattletales.
Right.
And, you know, that sort of thing. So I want more female characters to go on more adventures, doing crazy things,
mm-hmm.
and not only picks flowers, smells them, and talk about boys.
That's
what I would like.
Yes.
And that's why I love Pony so much.
Yes.
Because they don't.
They don't.
They go on adventures.
More
and they
Laura
do stuff.
Croft.
Yeah.
More Laura Croft.
Certainly. Yes. And I actually do another show that Amelie Hiet does as well.
Uh-huh.
It's called Legend of Korra.
Yes, Legend of Korra. Absolutely.
Yeah. And I play Korra.
Mm-hmm.
And I love doing that show as well because she kicks butt and she takes names mm-hmm. and she doesn't apologize for being who she is, but no. she tries to help and she tries to, and she, oh, she is, I love that show and I love doing it.
Awesome.
Because, yes, because of this, mm-hmm. that she is a female character that the whole land is kind of turning to help them out. And, she's like, oh, no, I love it. So it's good.
Awesome.
So more characters like
more
that
characters
for
like
women.
That. And that's what that's what the Gina Davis Institute on Gender in Media does. It brings
yes.
to attention to people. It's like, look, you're not giving girls or women enough juicy roles and good role models for young women.
Exactly.
This is what we're about. This is what Lauren Faust was about in doing this show. Guess what? This is the perfect opportunity for us to do wonderful things.
I, I thought that perfect. The Brony community would kind of like this charity. Yeah.
This is perfect.
And I thought so. So I chose carefully.
You chose carefully, and you chose well.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
I'm glad you think so.
If you go to manliesbrony.com and you click on the link over there, it'll take you to their website. Now, this is going to be a little different this time, so listen up. They have their own charity page there, okay? So, pick the little click box on their site. It'll take you to PayPal. What you need to do this time is you need to give your charity donation to them, get your PayPal confirmation number, okay? And then you're going to have to email it to me, dusty@manliesbrony.com. It's the only way I'm going to be able to figure out that you've actually given some money to them, because we couldn't set up our own little site this time because they don't do that over there. So when you give your donation to C. Jane, you're going to take your PayPal confirmation number and you're going to send it to me in email so that I can put you on the list for the giveaway for this stuff right here. First things first. I have cards from the series. This is The Great and Powerful Trixie. This is Princess Luna. And this is our favorite male mare, Derpy. So these are up. These are just your standard cards, nothing special. But I thought, because, you know, we have the Swedish voice actress of these three mares, we're going to throw that in. Second, we have this wonderful present right here, sent to us by Pink Pearl Apple. Thank you, Pink. I don't know what's in here. I have no idea what's in this box, but you're going to get it. And you're going to tell us what's in this box when you get it, because nobody knows what's in here except for Pink Pearl Apple. So that, you're getting a present that I have known nothing about. Isn't that awesome? I think it's cool. But not only that, if we break 500 bits, you're going to get one of the very first autographs from Miss Fina on brand new Pixel Kitty's autographed art. Isn't that not correct?
Yes, that is correct.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, Pixel just did this wonderful art.
Especially, yeah.
Wonderful art.
Beautiful. I am so impressed with her.
Yes, she is awesome.
Amazing. Awesome. Oh, yeah.
So, she just did this art like in the last few days. It's beautiful.
Yep.
She's sent it to Fina. Fina is going to print it. She's going to sign it. She's going to mail it to me. So that when we do this drawing in 2 weeks, I can send it to you. If we break 500 bits. So, get out there. Get your friends out there. Get your parents out there. Get anybody you know out there. Because this is a wonderful charity that needs our help. So, and it's right in the meat and byproducts that we like to do around here.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So, that.
Yay.
Yes. Yay. I'm going to put this present back here under the tree because I got the tree going. So the present goes under the tree over here.
Yes. Do it.
And the pop figure goes back over here like that. Under the tree. Under the tree. Just like that. And with that, we are done with charity for the week. Remember how to do it. We're going to have notes over there on manliesbrony.com too. So don't forget, you have to email me with a confirmation number or you're not in at all. So do it right this time.
Do it.
Do it.
Email.
Do it. You know, Fina.
Yeah.
I've lost my co-host again. I've lost him. I don't know where he is. He's up in Alberta under 15 feet of snow. So I need you to call. I need you to call for Screwball because I can't find him. Screwy. Screwy.
Yo.
Should I call him?
Yes. Call him.
I'm right here.
Oh.
Sorry.
It's fine. God.
I'm just waiting. I'm like, oh, okay. Yeah.
Screwball. No, it's not.
Yes. Come on, Dusty. It's not 15 feet of snow, but it, surprisingly enough, the past few weeks has been like minus 50 degrees Celsius and 30 and so on and so forth. This time it's actually plus 4 right now. And we're like, okay, whatever.
You're colder than Sweden.
We have the same here. It's weird.
Weird. Colder than Sweden.
I don't know, but I'm glad that it's so warm out. It's like t-shirt and shorts weather.
Oh, it's not.
Yeah, it is in Canada.
It is for Alberta.
I'm not even kidding. I actually did see a couple of people in t-shirts and stuff. I'm like, you guys are, you're just living
you're
the Canadian
crazy.
Dream.
You are crazy and manlier than the Swedes.
Nuts. So I'm sure we have a lot of wonderful people in our audience who have been asking wonderful questions.
Oh yeah, there's a fudge ton.
Fudge cakes.
A fudge ton.
Oh my god, so much fudge.
Yes.
So I'll bring it right on ahead.
Do it.
So this one's from Wason, I think is how you say the name. Question is, what kind of voices do you enjoy doing the most? And that means like everything out there is what I'm guessing.
Yeah. Oh, it's hard. It's really fun when you get to tweak your voice, when you get to really work with your with it. And work with your voice and make it sound nothing like you.
Yeah.
That is a huge challenge, and I really like and enjoy that. But I also like when I don't do so much of a voice and do more acting,
mm-hmm.
like I do in Legend of Korra, because Korra sounds pretty much like me.
Okay.
I'm just, she's a little higher, mm-hmm. higher pitch because she's supposed to be a teenager. So she's a little higher pitch, but it's acting,
mm-hmm.
really, really acting. And I really enjoy that as well. So that's also why I like Pony,
mm-hmm.
because it's both acting and tweaking your voice, because a lot of times it's just, you know, really high tempo in the studios and just, yeah, we don't have time to do second takes.
Mm-hmm.
So you just, Say the line and move forward. And I'm kind of a perfectionist, so that's really hard.
Mm-hmm.
So I very, very seldom walk away from a studio session thinking, God, I really nailed that one. You know? it's usually, oh, damn, I'm so darn sorry. I didn't mean to swear. sorry. And I... So I'm like, oh, why didn't I say it like that? Why didn't I go this way? Why didn't I do it that way? Or, that line bothers me still. And that's I think I answered the question, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
Okay, good. Good. One win. So, that's what I enjoy. And I like challenges. I like to be challenged in my work. So hard stuff is fun.
Oh yeah, you don't want it to be the same old boring thing over and over again, right?
No, of course. But I mean, it's a job. Everything mm-hmm. becomes a job, even though it's the most fun job ever. It's easy that it becomes a job. So you have to find ways to make it your own and make it fun for you when you're in there doing it, because people will tell if you're having fun.
Absolutely.
Or if you're not.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So this one is from Gavin Japp. A question for Fina. What would you want to voice act in and why?
What would I like to voice act in and why? Excellent question. There's so much. I mean, I can make up stuff. I would like if they made, let's say, a Wicked movie.
Ooh,
I
yeah.
don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd say you'd have to dub it in Swedish because a lot of kids would like to see it. So that's something I would love to dub if I had to make up something on the top of my head. If it's something that already exists, a show that already exists that I would like to voice,
mm-hmm.
I'll have to think for a moment. let's see. Oh, I see stuff all the time where I'm like, oh, I would love to do that. I like the action stuff.
Okay.
I like Avengers,
mm-hmm.
and that sort of thing, but that's such a sausage fest, you know? It is.
Yeah,
so,
you see that? Like, you know what? I can just see Fina, right? Wonder Woman walks on the stage, right?
Yeah.
She comes up to all the Avengers and just walks in the middle of them and goes, man, this is such a sausage fest in Swedish. I can see it. I can just see it.
Yeah, good. I can too. So I would love to. I actually did Wonder Woman once when she was a guest character in a Batman.
Yeah.
So that was a huge geek moment for me.
There you go.
Yeah. So I like that action things, and that's. So I guess. And I've heard a lot of Littlest Pet Shop.
Yeah.
And I heard people really like that show. So. Mm-hmm. Why not a new reoccurring character there, maybe?
Mm-hmm.
Or Gravity Falls is also a great
show. Oh, yes.
Great
yes.
Show.
Yes.
My, yes, yes. My fiance actually directs it here in Sweden.
Ooh,
so we,
you're kidding.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, and we watch it a lot, and it's so funny.
It's so funny.
But I was just, and he, of course, he is one of my biggest fans, so he really wanted me to be in it, but I was just going to have a baby when he was going in production with mm-hmm. that one, so he couldn't cast me, because...
Darn.
But,
I would
yeah,
have
darn.
Shucky
darn. Mabel.
Yeah, but
I Mabel?
Sorry?
You think it could pull off a Mabel? That would be pretty awesome.
Maybe I could pull up Mabel, but I haven't watched it so much in English. I'm not mm-hmm. sure how she sounds in the original language, since we watch it mostly in Swedish.
Mm-hmm.
But she is so funny. I love the Mabel character.
Cool.
She is an adventurous lady.
Yes.
Like we want with the cherry.
Yes.
So it's brilliant. I really like it. So
do it, Screwy.
Those are a few ones.
This one's more of a... well, first, Pink Pearl Apple wants to ask if you guys liked your presents.
I haven't opened them yet. It's not Christmas.
Yeah, I guess
they're,
that makes
they're
sense.
They're under the
tree. That makes
over
sense.
There.
And
we are going to... You know what? I'm going to tell you. I'm Pink, hang around, because I'm going to tell you about it later on in the program. Okay? Don't go nowhere. We have a special announcement near the end of the program. Don't go nowhere.
Oh, sounds exciting.
And also what Pearl wants to say is like she says, I also wanted to tell Amy the box her present is in a Pop-Tart box. It's not Pop-Tarts.
Okay, Amy, the present that Pink Pearl Apple sent you is in a Pop-Tart box. It's not Pop-Tarts, just so you know. Okay, done.
That's hilarious.
She really is over there, people. Yes.
Ooh.
I'm telling you, she's right there.
This one.
You don't think... You think I'm lying, don't you? You
no,
think I'm lying.
You totally
that she's over
lying.
There.
Who, me?
No. The viewing public does not... does not. You don't think she's over there, right? You don't think so? Look. See? She's right there. Making stuff for Christmas. Hi, honey. Wave to the peoples.
Hi.
Yes, there we go. Okay, we're back. Next.
This one is from Sony Star Sprite. Starbright, sorry. Question is, did you all enjoy the Daring Do episode, and what was your most favorite moment from it?
The Dairy Do episode. Which one was that? Please remind me.
Daring Don't, which is the one that just
Daring
came out.
Don't.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago. Rainbow Dash goes, and the girls go after, try to help A.K. Yearling finish the book.
Oh, yeah. A.K. Yearling thing.
Yeah.
I thought it was good. I don't think I had time to finish that episode.
Uh-huh.
So I don't know how it ends.
Mm.
So no spoilers.
Not spoiling it.
No
spoilers.
Because I tried to find it and go chronologically,
uh-huh.
but it started playing the... I watched it all in the wrong order. But I have had like 10 minutes left of that episode,
uh-huh.
so I'm really excited to see how it ends, but my son kind of stopped me dead in my tracks when I was watching it.
Well,
so
I won't spoil it for you, but Ali Zotto wins.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, well, really, Dusty?
No, not really.
What just happened?
No, he does. No.
Okay.
One part that honestly made me laugh my butt off was The Lord of the Rings scene with the ring going into the fire, and they all just look at it and they're like, I'm not grabbing that. And as soon as I saw that moment, I instantly thought of Raiders of the Lost Ark. Yep. When that guy grabs the medallion with his hands
and burns it. Yeah.
I thought for sure a pony was going to do that. I was just begging for it to happen, but it didn't happen. I'm like, ah, darn it. That's like a pure setup to Indiana Jones. I'm so shocked.
Well, then Daring Do use the whip, and therefore she is Indiana Jones.
Yeah, I guess so.
You know, yeah, and nowhere else, and nowhere else in the whole couple of times she's been in the thing does she actually have a whip. And all of a sudden, she has a whip. It's like, yeah. Awesome! Yes.
Yeah, I saw
a lot
that.
A lot of people believe that she's just a huge fan of Indiana Jones. That there's an Indiana Jones pony somewhere out there, and she's just like, that's her idol.
Yeah, probably.
I'll bring on the next question. here we go. So this one's from Dirty Kitten. That name. Needs
Dirty
a wash.
Yeah.
Well, I'm a dusty cat. Because I'm a dusty cat. That's Dirty Kitten.
Oh, I love it. That's a question for all. If any of you hit the ever-growing Mega Millions jackpot, what would you do with it? And he said, if I won it, I would give $2,500 per week for each charity mentioned on your show for the next few years.
That would be awesome. Thank you very much.
That would be awesome.
That would be awesome. I would, if I hit that thing, I'd take the lump sum, I'd give it to a money manager and said, look, I want to make $300,000 a year out of this money. And then I would do something charitable with a big chunk of it. But whatever I needed so that I could make $300,000 in a paycheck out of that money, and then whatever's left, do something good with.
Yeah.
That's all I need.
That's a great plan.
I like
I'm
that.
I'm going to copy that answer. I'm going to
copy
that answer.
Save it as much as you can. Don't spend it all in one go. It's like, hey, a $20 million house. Let's go for it. Woo!
No, we don't do that.
Yeah. No, I don't think so.
I would just resort right down to Vancouver. That's
hey,
my...
you know what I'd do? I'd throw a My Little Pony convention in Las Vegas.
Dusty.
Do you know what I'd...
No, I wouldn't.
I'm just thinking about this. I'm like, is this a good idea?
Maybe we should.
How'd you
start...
going, didn't I?
Maybe we should like open up a theme park, a My Little Pony theme
Ooh,
park.
Ooh, My Little Pony theme park.
Wouldn't
or,
that
or,
be awesome?
Or get with like Great America and say, I want to buy this little section of your theme park so I can put in something.
Exactly.
I like that. I like that idea. Instead of an entire theme park, a section of somewhere, and then, yeah, that would work out real well.
Yeah, a section, and then all the some of the money you spend there goes to charity.
Yeah, there you go. Done.
See?
Perfect.
Perfect. We sold it.
Now we must win those millions.
Ah.
Next.
Can we dream? Here we go. So this one is from Callow. Question for Josefina. Since you're a voice actress yourself, I'm interested. Do you prefer watching movies/shows in Sweden or with the original dubs?
Both. Since we're not the type of country that dubs everything.
Okay.
Like Germany and France, they dub everything.
Yes.
it's insane. So when I say I watch Modern Family and Friends, I watch it in the original language, which is, you know, English. And that's why I think Swedes are often very good at the English language.
There you go.
Because we watch it from childhood up to, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So we're kind of, we're listening to it every single day. But when it comes to cartoons, when it comes to the shows I do,
mm-hmm.
I like to watch both because it's learning and it's interesting from a voice actress point of view to see how it's made in English, because I always try to keep the original
mm-hmm.
character. So I try to get to know the characters, and that's when I have, because in a studio I don't have time to do that. So usually when I'm going to a new show, or if I'm doing something new, I look it up on the internet and find an episode or two to watch to see if I'm already cast or if I'm doing a voice test. I find out something more that I can, so I can have something behind it. So I have some thoughts when I go into the studio. So I'm just not a completely empty slate. But that's kind of a good habit, bad habit, I don't know. But it's the nice thing about dubbing is the voice acting is you don't have to come prepared if you don't want to. Mm-hmm. Because when I work in shows or musicals, you have to be prepared. Mm-hmm. And so you can practically just show up at the studio and say, okay, what do you have for me today? If you like. And that's really free, like, to be able to do that. But, oh my God, what was the question? What was the question? Screwball! What was the question?
Oh, fudge cakes.
Fudge cakes!
I kind of backed.
Moving on! Moving on!
No, I can't control Z this.
Moving on!
It won't work!
No, oh my God, no. So I watch both. That was the question. I watch both the Swedish dubs, and I watch the original English. For educational purposes and to make myself a better voice actress.
Nice.
Does that answer the question?
Yes.
I hope it did.
Answers
okay,
the question.
Good.
Of course it does.
Yes. Good.
Cool.
Next.
So this one's from Ozzy MOP. Question to all, what do you want for Christmas? And before two front teeth jokes.
Damn it, Screwy!
I got it from you!
Two front teeth. What do I want for Christmas? Peas on a roof?
Peas on a roof? What?
Peas on roof, yes.
Peas on roof?
Pee on the roof. That's what I want. Peas on roof.
Well, check it for reindeer later, but there you go.
You go, I think. I'll think. You go, Dusty.
Okay. I have everything I need. Really, I've been given so much this year, I don't really want anything else.
But no. Not what you need for Christmas, it's what you want for Christmas.
I know that. I know. It's what I want for Christmas. You know, what I want for Christmas would be a new bass amp. I have my eye on one, but I'll be saving for it. But the whole, you know, I don't really, you know, Pink Pearl Apple sent me something that was very nice. The, and cards are fine. You know, I don't need anything from the fans. I get more from the fans than I could ever hope for. So,
aww. You're sweet.
I ditto that comment, definitely. I've noticed that a lot of people have been asking for my address and stuff, and I'm like, okay, I did whatever, send me cards, I'm perfectly fine with this. And so now, and even GM Burrow is sending me something, and I'm just like freaking out because I think I know what it is.
Yep.
I know what I want for Christmas.
Oh, it's hard.
What do you want?
I want an invitation to a convention.
Ooh.
That's what I want for Christmas.
Do it.
Yeah.
Hey, Finnish MLP convention. Guess what? She's available.
I'm available.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, that's what I want. That would be so much fun.
That would be awesome. Yes.
Yeah.
I really don't have anything on my Christmas list, and whenever my parents or my brother or anyone asks me, I'm just like, I got nothing. I got all I want, so.
I know, it's hard. My brother asked me too, what do you want for Christmas? And I was like, are we doing Christmas presents, really? I'm like,
as soon as you get older, it's just impossible to buy for someone anymore.
I sent stuff to my niece and my nephews, and everybody else gets a card.
So, yeah.
You know, my girlfriend gets something nice, and... my roommate gets something nice, and my niece and nephews get something nice, and everybody else gets a card.
Yeah, I think that's enough. I mean, we usually have, we in Sweden, you can buy like charity stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So we usually do that. So you can buy a card where it says, you have received a gift card for 10 vaccines or a new well in Africa, a village in Africa, and you give that to someone and says, yeah, that's what I put your money for your Christmas present on instead.
That's cool.
So that's what we usually do.
Nice.
But this year, everybody's getting a picture of our baby. Oh, it's like, oh, gee, thanks. Gee. But no, so that's so we're trying not to spend too much money on Christmas presents and, right. and stuff. It's like kind of dial it down a little bit. Yeah. But
until the baby's old enough to understand what Christmas is, then crank it
yeah.
up. Crank.
Yeah. Yeah. But he's gonna get presents from everyone.
Yeah.
So we don't have to give him a mountain
yeah.
of stuff.
There you go.
As well. So we're like, well, we're buying something. And
clothing.
Then again, he's... Yeah, clothing. Yeah, he's like, yay, yeah. thank you.
He's growing now, so it's like...
yeah, he's growing. Oh, my God. Yeah.
Next!
So this one is from...
James Justice! Resident superhero.
I didn't quite catch that.
Didn't quite catch that? James Justice! Resident superhero of Stay Brony, my friends. Savior of us from the cornflake. Fiend.
The cornflake.
Yes. What does James want to know this week?
Question for all. What do you guys think about Daring Do being real?
Yeah, it could have went either way. I had my suspicions that Daring Do would be real because there are certain things in the background I know that are going on that I can't say. But, yes, secrets and lies. But I had an inkling suspicion that she would be real.
I thought it was cool.
I thought it was cool. I mean, it could have went either way. It could have been, this whole thing could have been like, you know, Bobby Ewing waking up in the shower. Which is basically,
yes.
you know, Rainbow Dash wakes up from a nap, you know, with a book over her face. It's like, whoa, that was cool. They could have done that, but...
Still, for all I know, that could still happen.
That could still happen.
Since I haven't finished the episode.
You never know.
But it's they did a really good job at hiding it for me because I've seen the synopsis and that sort of thing, but even the synopsis said something like Rainbow Dash is going to help Daring Do with her book.
Yeah.
And I thought really all I ever thought that was going to be was that as they're writing it, it's going to do what it did in the first episode. It's going to go back and they're trying to help each other out. But then I saw what's her name, AK Yearling,
mm-hmm.
and then I'm like, she looks awfully a lot like Daring Do. You know what, maybe I'm just tripping and now she can't be real. sure enough
there she is. Sure enough. Next.
Sorry, one sec.
Sorry.
I just don't know what went wrong.
Okay, then this question works perfect with this. this is for Fireman. Question is, when you got the script for the last roundup, what was the description of the character you voiced, and when did you realize it was Derpy?
Well, I didn't realize it was Derpy until... I had no idea how huge that character was for
mm-hmm.
the fans,
mm-hmm.
Since I was kind of in the blue about her. I realized it was Derpy just before the interview with Osaka Jack, like a couple of months ago. So that's when I realized how loved she was by the fans.
Mm-hmm.
Because I thought she was adorable, but I didn't know anything of her backstory when I voiced her. Actually, is anybody there?
Yeah, we're here.
Hello.
Yeah, we're here. We're holding on your every
like,
word.
Oh my God. yeah. So it was just just a couple of months ago that I realized, and I did some background checks on her, mm-hmm. and realized, oh my God, she is so popular, mm-hmm. and oh, she's so sweet. I love her.
Yes.
More derpy for everybody.
More derpy for everybody.
Yes. Yeah.
Next.
I like this one. I think it's been asked before in the past, but this one's from Trailblaze. Mm-hmm. To all, what would be your dream crossover with ponies?
Mm. Oh. Do you have anything interesting?
Crazily enough, pony crossed with, like, the Disney Afternoon. Either Tailspin or Rescue Rangers or something like that. I could see. This is how I see it. I see it now. I see it in my mind's eye right now. The magic mirror has infinite dimensions. Not only could it take Twilight to the human world, but it could take a pony to the Rescue Rangers universe. And I see Rainbow Dash goes through the mirror because she has to help Chip and Dale with a mystery. And she almost blows it because of her ego, but she learns the lesson that you have to sometimes listen to others and help, other than trying to be so gregarious, because she almost blows the case because you need to be sneaky and not mess with the evidence, but you have to actually, to be a detective, you have to be better than that. And it's a whole warm, lovey-dovey ending, and then she goes back through the portal, back to Equestria, better than she was, with the help of Chip and Dale.
I am hooked.
Thank you. Thank you. I can see it's an entire spin-off series, The Magic Mirror of Equestria. And each of the ponies goes to a new dimension and has to learn or teach the magic of friendship to other dimensions.
I am hooked.
I can see it.
Please, someone do this. This sounds amazing.
Megan McCarthy, you know I'm available for, you know, bar mitzvahs or any writing that you can.
Call me. I was, well, what about you, Fina?
Oh, I was hoping you'd forget about me. I'm just kidding. I am thinking, the possibilities are infinite.
Infinite.
That's some room.
Now, I want to see what Dusty said. What Dusty said.
There you go.
That was a boring answer, wasn't it? That was completely uninspired.
Okay, I'll give you one. How about this? Right? You know Legend mm-hmm. of Korra.
Yeah.
You play Korra. What would happen if Twilight Sparkle is dumped in the middle of Legend of Korra? What would happen?
Yeah, what would happen? And I was trying to think of a show that I wasn't a part of.
There you go.
Just to make it a little less about me, but I couldn't. And you
this
made it.
It's all about you. This show is all about you.
It's all about you.
Okay, so what would happen? That would be awesome, actually.
Would it?
I think Korra and Twilight Sparkle as a team would be unstoppable.
Unstoppable team. Yes.
They would be good doers.
Anili Heed would say, wouldn't you be an unstoppable team? Yes.
I like it.
I'm trying to think up a like 1980s action heroes or something. Like, I'm just thinking about one that's currently stuck in my head, I know, is maybe a Lethal Weapon reference with Riggs or something, or a Die Hard reference where he's like, hey, get together.
I've got it.
What?
Princess Celestia has dropped into She-Ra. Princess.
There you go.
And she's now She-Ra's new mount. Because She-Ra had that Pegasus, that white Pegasus that she rode around all the time, right? So Princess Celestia has dropped into She-Ra. See it now. Perfect.
You're painting such a picture.
I know. I'm telling you, Megan, I'm free anytime. Next.
Let's see. Oh my goodness.
I love your giggles, Dusty.
I know too much about 80s cartoons. Trust me.
So this one is from Violent Bray to all. What is your favorite holiday tradition? Also, Dusty, I noticed that you got the new Cheerilee Funrise plushie. Awesome.
Right there. She is awesome. I think I'm going to get out of the way.
So oh, I'm waiting right for there. My plushie that Joey made.
Right there. Casey sent me Princess Twilight Sparkle for Christmas. Thank you very much, Casey. I bought the other ones, but she sent me that one for free. Thank you.
Yes. That's amazing. Oh, I'm waiting for my plushie. I can't wait for her to get here.
It'll come.
Yeah. What traditions? What did you say?
Tradition?
Yeah, tradition. What is your favorite holiday tradition?
My favorite holiday tradition. Well, back when I was a kid, my favorite holiday tradition was we'd wake up in the morning and do our holiday at home. And then my grandparents, my mom's mom and dad, were actually one town south of us. So we would get up, do our Christmas at home, and then we'd jump in the car and we'd drive 10 miles to go to grandma's house. And it was basically over the river and through the woods, but it was along the river. And all of the cousins would be there, all of them. So my mom had one brother and three sisters. So we had cousins out the wazoo. So Ooh. It was the only time you got to see all your cousins at the same time was Christmas, so or Thanksgiving. So we'd go down there and we'd all bring a present from home and we'd get a present from grandma and grandpa. And there wasn't enough room in the house, obviously, to eat at the table, right? So all the adults ate at the table and all the kids got their plates and we sat on the stairs, right? So all the kids sat on the stairs and we took a picture on the stairs every year.
Aww.
And yeah, so my mom still has them, but it's like every year the kids would grow up on the stairs. It was really cool. So yeah, that was the holiday tradition is we took the picture on the stairs.
Yeah. Oh my god, that sounds amazing. Favorite holiday traditions? I don't know. This holiday, Christmas, or any holiday?
How about let's keep it to Christmas.
Keep it to Christmas.
Yeah.
Okay. I think I have to repeat my previous answer. Putting the wax on the presents.
Mm-hmm. Wax on the presents
for me. Yes. Yeah, wax on the present is my favorite holiday tradition for me.
Cool.
Yeah. not so inventive.
That's okay.
Mine is.
I don't know of any. I don't know of anywhere else in the world anybody does that. You know,
I never heard of it myself.
I've never heard of it until you just told me. It's like I don't know any other place in the world that somebody uses hot wax and a stamp to seal the presents.
I think it's not a typical Swedish thing. I think it's typical my family
then
thing.
Then there's family tradition. There you go.
Yeah. It's, yeah.
You know, mine is.
What is yours?
I like to eat all the mandarin oranges in sight.
For me, it's the devil eggs. Like, keep me away from the devil eggs.
Ooh. Keep me away from mandarin oranges. I'll eat them by the crate. I kid you not.
Next.
We have we have gingerbread cookies here.
Oh yeah,
a lot.
Well, that's another thing I'd eat
everywhere, and it's hopeless. I can't pass by them without eating like a handful.
Ooh,
it's you know a curse.
What?
No.
It's like my family makes it all the time. It's like what they do is they put a layer of Jell-O,
mm-hmm.
and then they let it go solid, and uh-huh. they put another layer and another and another till it's about five or six layers of Jell-O. And then uh-huh. they cut it into little cake pieces, and then you just eat it.
Oh yeah, my grandma made that.
I love it.
Usually made it in a sheet pan.
We don't have Jell-O in Sweden.
What?
What?
No Jell-O in Sweden.
This is blasphemy!
You know what? I need your address so that I can ship you Jell-O.
What?
I will send you seven different moldy. Flavors of Jell-O.
But
so you can make it
somehow. Oh my god! I didn't know this was good.
I will ship you seven different flavors of Jell-O so you can make that.
Oh right! Before you make it in powder form, I get it now.
And I think I'll be the one. We're vegetarians.
Oh, okay. Well, Jell is vegetarian.
Is it?
I think.
Because sometimes it's the gelatin is.
Oh yeah, the gelatin is. I'll check the package. If it has any meat stuff in it, I won't send it to you. I'll find a Jell-O version that is vegetarian. We got plenty of that here in the Bay Area.
Thanks. You do?
We'll figure. Oh yeah. There's a bunch of vegetarians around here in the Bay Area. I'll find some vegetarian Jell-O and I'll show it to you.
Yay! Thank you.
I will do that. That'll be my Christmas present to you. Will be vegetarian Jell-O.
Aw, thank you.
Yes.
I'm going to make it and I'm going to tweet a picture of it.
Yes.
Me eating Jell-O.
Yes.
They need it.
My very first Jell-O.
Next.
So this one is from Parasnow. Question. What inspired you to get into voice acting?
Oh, that's an excellent question. I have been dreaming about being a voice actor since I was like 8 or 9 years old. When first My Little Pony, no, sorry, it's on my mind. What can I tell you? The Little Mermaid.
Oh, there you go.
Came out, and I was obsessed with The Little Mermaid. Me and my friends used to sit with the tape recorder and listen to the tape version of it and try to sing like Ariel.
Okay.
In Swedish, though. Mm-hmm. In Swedish. And actually, that's funny. That's kind of interesting to me, anyway. The person who played Ariel in Sweden also did the Norwegian and the Danish dub, and I think that's unrepresented. Nobody's ever done that before. Before her, she did, and not since either. I think, because she's Norwegian, but she speaks Swedish and Danish. But she has its cutest accent in Swedish.
That's some talent, which is really,
yeah, and she's amazing. So we sat there and tried to do the. You know, try to do that over and over, try to sound just like her. So that's what inspired me from the very earliest beginning. Mm-hmm. And then I always fantasized what it would be like to stand in the studio and voice and throughout my teenage years and everything. And I decided if I ever move to Stockholm, I'm going to pursue this.
Cool.
And I did. And awesome. Here I am.
And here you are. Here you are talking to some crazy Americans about pastel ponies.
Yeah, and I'm loving
hey,
it.
Hey.
And Canadians.
I'm Canadian.
And you're Canadian.
Yeah.
We're North American.
North Americans. How's that?
Okay, yeah, that works.
Hey, Screwy.
Hey, Screwy. Yeah. What?
You know what time it is?
No. No, it isn't.
It is.
No, it isn't.
It is.
Aww.
This is long. It's time for the one last awesome, wonderful question that you've been saving, because I know you have.
For fudge cakes.
I know, fudge cakes. But we are at the end of the program. This lady needs to get her beauty rest, so let's make it good.
Okay.
Yes.
So this one's from Jamie. Question is, what is everyone's favorite childhood memory? Dun, dun, dun!
Dun, dun, dun! Crazy. My childhood was a long time ago.
Yo, I'll say Stone Ages.
Oh, thanks, Screwy. God. You know what you're getting for Christmas? A lump of coal. That's what you're getting. Oh, of course, you need it because it's cold up there. You need...
Dusty, he'll make... I take it back.
Lump of coal.
I'll make a diamond of it.
Yeah, I'll make a diamond of it. I'll pull a Superman.
Yeah.
Let me think. Favorite childhood. You know, I wouldn't call it childhood. Well, I would say the favorite. Okay, I can't think of the favorite, but I can think of one right now. I was a teenager, and I was a busboy at a 4-star seafood restaurant. And at that time, I was a hockey nut. I loved hockey, right? I still love hockey. But I'm doing my busboying thing, and as I'm walking through the restaurant looking for stuff to do, I keep passing by this one table, and I think I know that guy. But I've never met him before. I think I know that guy. And as he's leaving, it's like, I'm sorry, sir, but I feel that I know you from somewhere. Are you one of my former teachers or something? He said, no, I'm a hockey player. Really? And it just dawned on me. Dale Hunter? who was a great, huge name in hockey at the time. He played for the Quebec Nordiques. And I went, and Dale Hunter. And he gave, signed me an autograph, and I still have to this day. And it's like, yeah.
Aw, starstruck.
I think I was like 16 years old.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
I'm kind of thinking here. One of my favorite memories, something I can think of on the spot, is when I was 10, we went to Crete with my family. And they had these clubs, these children's clubs, right? And we had got to perform in a show.
Right.
And I wanted to sing something, but I was really nervous and scared. So I had a bunch of other kids dance behind me. They didn't really do anything, but I wasn't alone on stage, and that was the most scary thing. But I sang a song from a Swedish artist called Karola. So all the Swedish listeners will absolutely know who she is. And it's a song that she won the Eurovision Song Contest with in 1991. Do you know about the Eurovision Song Contest?
Yes, because I know who Lordi is.
Yeah, exactly. And she won the Eurovision Song Contest in 1991 with that song, and it's called Fångad av en stormvind. And I sang that, and that was so huge to me, and it was so much fun. And I started doing, you know, getting into it, lifting my arm at the end of the note and going, "La," with my arm up in the air. And I remember my dad was filming it, and I went the day after, I was like, "No, I have to go back. Please tell me I didn't do that with my hand. That would be so embarrassing." And I saw I did, and I was like, "No, I did it. Oh my God." But my mom was like, "But that's feeling. You did it with me. No, that's so embarrassing.
Do it again with feeling." Yes.
Yes, that was very good. Once more with feeling. Once thank more you. With feeling. That's the worst thing you can hear in the studio. Yes, good. Once more with feeling. You're like, I was
giving a feelings. What?
Make him a bit more over the top, Lee. Like this? Yeah.
Your turn, Screwball.
Yep.
Dear sweet Celestia. The only thing I can come up with was... dear sweet Lord. I remember when I was a kid, I had like... an enormous ant farm, and I absolutely adored it. And then what happened was, because of my so-called ant farm, it actually grew to size that actually got into the basement. And it's because of me, you know, I guess I could say nourishing it and making sure that it grows nice, big, and proud, that now that we, at that time we had ants just flooding the basement. I'm not even kidding. And it's my parents are like, "This is all your fault." And then it only got worse because then they had to renovate my bedroom. So I was forced to sleep downstairs. And I was like freaking out because I'm like, "What if they eat me alive? I hope that they actually thought that I was their god or sign." I don't know. I can't.
Is this your best childhood memory?
And on that note, where Screwball becomes Ant-Man.
I like this.
Yes. We're going to go out with the weekly call-out sheet of the wonderful, original stuff that you can come back here to watch every week here on Everfree Network. We start off with this show on Monday nights, which is Stay Brony, My Friends. You're here already, so don't go away. But you can also check the Cutie Art Crusaders on Tuesdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. The CAC Find and the best art the fandom has to offer and tells you why it is so good. Then, The Inventory at KPNY, which is odd Wednesdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. It is a radio drama where ponies of Equestria discover Earth's internet and bronies. What happens? Well, it's a radio drama. Come and find out. And then, Equestrian Inquirer is back on Wednesdays, and it is 6 p.m. Pacific, 9 p.m. Eastern. The source of truth in Equestria. Come back and check it out. Into the Spotlight with Asaka Jack, which is Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. Eastern, focuses on the person behind the brony, or this lovely lady back here over my shoulder, who's also been on that program. Sketchy Sounds Live Songcast, Thursdays, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern, 2-hour live set of acoustic music played by Sketchy for you. Come check him out. Post my video with Jay Holler and BVids Thursdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. The premier video and animation showcase, interviews, guests. It'll get a little bit better because Jay Holler has finished Anthology 3 and now he can sleep. Lunar Republic Takeover, Fridays, 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern on the radio side. That is where Nightmare Moon herself takes over the radio and plays all of your requests from the chat room. Check that one out. Mixology with DJ One Trick and DJ Midley, Saturdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. These two awesome DJs take over the stream and bend your ears with all the awesome wubs and tunes that you could ever want. Eastern Sounds with Frozen Sound, Saturdays, 11 a.m. Pacific, 5 a.m. Eastern, is a two-hour live mix of European dance music. Scheduled for our European time zone friends. Saturday Night Songs with Michelle Krieber when they're not busy. Saturday nights, 7 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. Eastern. Krieber Clan will bring you all the fun on Saturday nights. Blue Screen Bronies, Sundays, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. The guys help you find the good games. It's the gaming show. Avoid the bad games. Let's find out what's going on with the Xbox One thing. I don't know. Pegasisters Live, Sundays, 7 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. Eastern, where Emily, Jay, and Tay will do the same thing that we do here, kind of, but from the Pegasisters' point of view. And that is all the wonderful original stuff you can come back and watch right here on Everfree Network every week. And with that, we are going to do a couple of things. One, we have a new t-shirt design. I hope you guys are picking up your t-shirts because check out that graphic right there with me and Scurry. Brand new t-shirt. It is on redbubble.com. Look for Everfree Network. You'll find it there. And they're pretty cheap. They're kind of good. They're awesome. I have one. It's neat. So we want to see you guys wearing that to the cons this year.
I want one.
You want one? Cool.
I want one.
Cool. We'll check it out.
I'm getting one.
Sweet. I'll give you the link later. Thanks. And then I want you guys to stick around for the outro, brand new outro, which premiered last show. We're going to bring it again, which was done by Filming's Magic. The Filming's Magic team did us a brand new outro, so check that out. Now, the special event, which I hinted to earlier for Pink Pearl Apple. See this tree right here? It's going to be lonely without you. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to turn this camera on Christmas Eve, and we're going to leave it running. We're going to have a manly Christmas Eve. But we're not going to do it on the EFN network. We're going to do it on my new live stream channel, Manliest Brony. So go to live stream, look up Manliest Brony, and you'll find my channel there. And we're going to turn it on Christmas Eve, and we're going to just have Christmas Eve. If you have no Christmas Eve to go to, come and check us out. We're going to have a Christmas Eve for you. And we'll do, I don't know what we're going to do yet, but we're going to do something. We're going to have a Christmas tree for you, and we're going to have all that stuff. My friends are going to be over. We might have a couple of surprises, but come and check it out. Manliest Brony live stream, okay? And we'll do it Christmas Eve. Not sure exactly what's going to start yet. Check out the webpage, manliestbrony.com, for more details later in the week. And we'll do that. So thank yous go out to Pink Pearl Apple for sending us this awesome present. To Film Is Magic for doing our new outro. Babs Con, Care to Win, my lovely girlfriend. Right over there. And then Screwball for rushing home in the freezing cold, when it's freezing cold.
It's really nice out today.
It's really nice out today, though. And of
it's
course...
t-shirt weather.
Of course. Yeah. Fina for staying up with us this evening.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you for coming.
Yes. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. And don't be a stranger. You know, you see us around. Say hi. Say hi.
Of course.
Absolutely.
I can't wait until next time.
Yes. So I'll get a hold of you to get the thing from here, and I'll sell you the Jello, and we'll all be great. And hey, two weeks from now, which is after Christmas, the last show of the year, Dave Polsky, writer of last week's episode. Hey, ooh. Dave Polsky's gonna be here.
Great guest.
Absolutely. So with that, we're gonna see you guys tonight. I have to go to my bass lesson because I got an hour to get to my bass lesson. So I will catch you guys later next time. And like I said, Christmas Eve, Manliest Brony live stream. And we'll check out more with that on the manliestbrony.com website. And we'll catch you later. Bye bye.
Bye.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go. We hate to leave you, but we'll be back soon. Good night, sweetheart. Good night. Good night, sweetheart. Good night.